A help desk does exactly what its name suggests. It's there to help your visitors when problems arrive. If you want to add a help desk solution to your WordPress website, in this video, I'm going to show you how to do that step by step with the awesome support plugin. Awesome Support is the only help desk and support ticketing plugin that can match the feature set of SaaS solution such as Zendesk or Help Scout. So, let's add this feature-rich support plugin to your WordPress website. To get started, install and activate the Awesome Support plugin. This plugin offers many free features without having to upgrade. However, I recommend checking out the premium version if you're trying to integrate with WooCommerce, for example. Once you activate the plugin, it will prompt you to click here to start the setup process. The first part of the Quick Start Guide asks whether or not you'd like to turn on support for multiple products. If you are only selling one product, or if you'd like all of your tickets to go to one person, you should select No. However, companies with multiple products are better off if they give customers the chance to specify. If anything, it helps you narrow down what the problem is. You'll also have to create a menu to show the Submit My Ticket tab. If you don't already have a menu, the tutorial provides a link to create a menu. You can skip this step or any other step in this process by clicking on Not Right Now. I recommend a complete tutorial on how to create a menu. You can check the recommended video above or the links in the description box below later. If you want to know how to add these beautiful icons to your menu, be sure you check out that video. Let's continue with the help desk implementation. Once you have a menu, you can specify which menu you want to add the Submit Ticket page to. The same goes for My Tickets page, which is where your customers see open tickets. If you don't want to place this option on your main menu, other good places include your footer, sidebar, or a drop-down under Apparent Support option. The next step asks if you'd like to specify priorities on your tickets. Priorities help you see which tickets need to be dealt with first. Finally, if you have multiple support departments, make sure you create all of those departments in the dashboard. I'll show you how to do that, but for now, you can mark the Yes button and click Continue. Proceed to the last window to land back on the WordPress dashboard. Just like that, your website has a help desk. To test it out, log out and then go to the front end. Select the Submit Ticket option on your menu. Register as a test user and create an account. You can then view what your customers will see every time they submit their own ticket. For instance, they have a subject field, description, department, product, and attachments. Upon submitting a ticket, the users can then navigate to the My Ticket page to check on statuses. Head back to your normal WordPress dashboard and then click on the All Tickets tab, where you'll see which tickets are open, in progress, and closed. To reply, click on the ticket title of your choice, or you can click on the Edit link as well. Don't worry if you accidentally click on the trash or close, because both actions can be reverted. For example, if you accidentally click on the trash link, you can restore that ticket back by clicking on the restore link here. If you click on close by mistake and you want to reopen that ticket again, filter out closed tickets like so, and set that ticket back in its open state again. Moving back to Tickets Management, you can update a ticket, reply, or you can reply and close that ticket as well by clicking this button. If you just want to close a ticket, then click on the close link here. If we go back to all tickets, we can see that there's also information involving the agent, current status, and open tickets on the same page. Finally, if you'd like to add additional tags, departments, priorities, or channels, those tabs are available right on the dashboard. If you are a big business with multiple departments, you can add them one by one here, just like creating a category for your posts. Add a name for your department, then click on Add New Department below. Once you finish adding all of your departments, clients can choose one of them in this drop-down list before submitting a ticket. If you have only one department, or you have no departments at all, you can completely disable the departments management by unchecking this option in the General Settings tab. Once you click on the Save Changes below, you'll notice that the Departments tab is no longer active in the Tickets Management menu. If you have multiple users with administrative rights, you can change the default assignee in this dropdown. Further down, you can choose the number of tickets and replies per page on the front end. Let's say we want to have 7 instead of 5. Change this number and that's it. Moving down, you can select the number of replies per page on a ticket details screen. And you can choose to hide closed tickets for admins and for clients on the front page too. If you want to see how many tickets you have in the admin menu, check this box or leave it as it is by default. Departments management is something you already know how it works, so move down and choose your priority management options and multiple agents ticketing. You can check the boxes as needed, or you can simply let them as they are by default. I want to keep this video as simple as possible, so I won't go deep into these options. Moving down, the options in the section control which dates show up in the activity column in the ticket list. The more fields you turn on, the taller the row. Tall rows mean you can view fewer tickets on one screen. Sometimes, though, seeing all these dates can help with troubleshooting issues, especially those related to reporting. Further down, you can control whether certain tabs are visible at the top of the admin ticket list. Let me show you what's happening exactly. If you uncheck that boxes, you will deactivate these tabs. And if you check them back and save the changes, they will become active again. It's your choice which tab is important to you and which not. The Ticket Details tabs and Meta Boxes fields are more advanced options which you can choose. If you want to control who can view certain tickets tab on the Ticket Details screen, in WP Admin, then you should enter a comma-separated list of roles in these fields, like so. Further down, you can configure where the user should be redirected after certain actions. Enter the full URL starting with HTTP or HTTPS in this field to set a logout redirect page, the home page for example, and if you want to have a custom page where the user will be redirected after opening a new ticket, this is the field where you should enter a link. The plugin creates ticket submission and ticket list pages automatically, once installed. But if you want to replace them with custom pages, you can use these shortcodes to display the ticket submit form and the tickets list anywhere you want. Just copy those shortcodes and paste them into the editor of your page, like so. We can click on Save Changes before moving to the next tab. If you'd like to customize the style of the tickets, for example, you can change the theme and colors in the Style tab like so. I do prefer to leave these settings as they are by default, but you are free to play around, then remember to click on Save Changes before moving on. Actually, we should move back to the Registration tab, which has a lot of important features. For example, if you want to allow users registration, even though your Anyone Can Register WordPress setting is off, if you check Allow Registrations here, you will allow users to register on the support page. Want to be the only one who receives the standard WordPress notifications when a new user registers on the site? Check only the site admin box then. And if you want both the customer and the admin to be notified, check this box. If no one should receive notifications, check this box and then save the settings. Further down, if you want to customize how should usernames be determined, check your preferred option here. I will leave this how it comes by default, but you are free to use whatever you want. Moving down, you can add a description to each of the registration fields, which will appear beneath the field. You can use this to add GDPR-related information indicating what each field is used for. If you work with clients within the European Union, you need to comply with the new GDPR regulations. So, these are three of the GDPR compliant checkboxes you will have to enable on your registration form. If you add notice terms in any of these boxes, a mandatory checkbox will be added in the registration form. Users won't be able to register if they don't accept those terms. You can customize how an email sent out to your clients and users will look like in this tab. Logo, header, footer, sender name, sender email, and so on. Then if you want to change any of these tags, or you want to add more content and more tags in the email templates, you can use the ticket email template tags here. Save your changes and then go to the next tab. If you sell more than one product, then you need to provide support for multiple products. If so, enable this option. You will then be able to add your products here, just like adding categories. Would you like to show the basic time tracking fields? Then you should check this box. Further down, feel free to enable or disable any of these options, as needed. If you want to allow your users and agents to upload attachments to tickets and replies, you should leave this box checked and then you can set the number of files and the file size allowed. As a security measure, I suggest you to only allow JPEG, PNG, GIF, PDF, and DOC files. This way, you'll avoid the archived or other file types that can come with unwanted content like viruses, for example. Because I want to keep this video as simple as possible, I will leave the options in the Advanced tab as they are by default. I won't go into the Integrations tab either, because there are premium add-ons involved and I want to remain in the free zone for now. The free version of Awesome Support sets you up with a fully functioning WordPress helpdesk. But if you ever need more functionality, Awesome Support has a huge variety of premium add-ons you can check out. And to offer even better support on your website, consider combining your new helpdesk with a WordPress knowledge base and a live chat plugin. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Like the video and subscribe if you are new here. Then, I recommend you check out this video with some of the best WordPress themes you can get for free. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.